It's Andre from the High Performance Academy. We're here at World Time Attack with Mark Jacobsen from Godzilla Motorsport. And we're just going to talk a little bit about what makes Mark's R35 GTR drag car tick. Now, currently, Mark's tube frame rear wheel drive R35 is the fastest rear wheel drive GTR anywhere in the world, running a best of 6.34 at 224 mph. Now, Mark, that's a fairly decent accomplishment. And what we really want to focus on here is what you've done to that engine, the VR38, in order to get the sort of power that you need to run those times. All right, Mark, let's start by talking about what sort of power levels you're seeing out of this VR38 engine. What's it making?
We reckon about 2200 plus.
In stock form, these are what, around about a 500 horsepower engine?
Probably about 400 horsepower at the wheels, yes, about 500 horsepower at the crank, yeah.
Okay, so on the face of it, that's a massive increase in power. What sort of modifications have you needed to make to that block to support 2200 plus horsepower?
Well, the block itself is pretty well a standard block. We use, you know, like a hard block, you know, like grout in the bores. You know, around the bores and that.
Now, that's what we're talking about there, is removing the water from the engine, so the block, all the water jackets are filled with a grout to strengthen the block.
Yes, and then we use a cast iron sleeve, which is about 5mm thick.
Now, a lot of these changes that you've made, or particularly the solid filling of the block, that's something that really is only suitable for drag racing and really only suitable with methanol fuel?
Yes, mate, that's correct. It's purely only for drag racing and just to give the, you know, the bores a little bit of extra, like, strength, you know, from the pressures, the boost pressures and that sort of stuff, yeah.
Now, a lot of people in the VR38 or GTR tuning market are now turning to billet blocks. And before we came on camera, I know you talked about you're having one made as well. Can you talk about the requirements for that billet block and where those prove to be an advantage over a stock cast alloy block?
Look, I think the billet block is going to really open up a whole new world of, you know, like, strength for the VR38. I mean, the engine itself is great with a girdle, and it's got all the strength, you know, like, things there. But to have a solid billet block where you can, you know, put a dry sleeve in, we can put on some bolt-on water plates, we can run water how we want it, oil how we want it, you know, bigger head studs, you know, the deck will be stronger, you know, there's heaps of advantages, eh? Like, it's like a top fuel block.
Now, you've just touched on something that's of interest to me from my own drag car tuning experiences, which was the head studs you mentioned, or sealing the head onto the block. Now, what a lot of people probably aren't aware of is when you're sort of starting to run 50, 60, 70 or 80 pounds of boost or more, really one of the limiting factors with any of these engines is sealing the cylinder head to the block. And particularly when you're talking about a production block, that can in some instances be incredibly difficult. How are you going about that now with the current block?
Oh, look, the standard block, right, we just run a permaseal, you know, just like a normal, you know, MLSR. It's about 1.1 mil thick. And then we run a stainless steel, a wire ring in, you know, like on the sleeve. And that's been fine up to 50, 60 pound of boost.
Now, that stainless steel ring that you're running, or wire O-ring, so that protrudes from the sleeve and the block and actually presses into the head gasket?
Yes, correct. It just puts extra pressure just sort of right on the stopper part of the head gasket. Yeah, so yeah.
Now, with the move to a billet block, and I know you're changing to a different specification of turbocharger, that coupled with the fact you're currently 2200 plus horsepower, we've seen the results that these R35 GTRs are making more in a street drag race trim. Where do you actually see the limiting power level on the GTR platform?
Probably the turbo size you're using, really. I mean, the guys over in the States, they're probably making 2,500 horsepower now easily. They normally run 80 millimeter turbos on them, possibly 82 mil turbos on them. They run about 65 or 70 pound of boost, and they're sort of at the limit now. But it'd probably just be turbo size and engine RPM they're running.
In terms of the rest of the rotating assembly, what challenges have you faced with getting reliability with the crankshaft and conrods and pistons?
Look, the crankshaft is just a standard one at the moment. It's been fine. It's been racing for 2 years. We've broken one crankshaft, but that's probably from more to do with maybe a tie shake. But we've got some other cranks, you know, some Bryant cranks there that we're probably going to put into the billet blocks.
So right up to even 2200 horsepower, that stock crankshaft has proven to be reliable. That in itself is quite amazing that a factory part will handle that sort of abuse. Look, Mark, it's been really interesting getting some insight into your engine. You're already the fastest in the world. Certainly look forward to seeing what you can do with a billet block, bigger turbos and a bit more moose. Thanks for chatting to us.
Cool. Now, thanks, Andre. Cheers.